Hey there guys, it is Qwerty Afro here. I'm bringing you another Train Simulator 2016 video. It's been quite some time. Most of my previous videos actually have just been pre-records from like a few weeks ago before I began the kind of intense kind of revision period for my exams. As you know, I'm kind of in exam season right now. I've completed one of my exams out of four, so I'm kind of happy about that, and also that I thought, you know, might as well record a bit of a video to de-stress as well. I don't have any actual pre-recorded train sim videos, so I thought I'd actually get on to doing like a bit of train sim as well for you guys. I don't want to leave you guys hanging. I know you guys want some train sim content as well. It's been mainly just bus content recently. I have a few things also in the works which I'll talk about in the actual video once we get through into it. The shoutouts for this video, if I just turn my head like slightly just to have a look, go to class380fan and Abdoulie Secka, I think that's how you pronounce it. That's again class380fan and Abdoulie Secka. Their links and stuff will be down below. Please do show them some love. So what you guys are wondering, where am I right now? What are we doing? Well, we are back in the class 442 Wessex train. You can see here, very nice cut. You're obviously going to distinguish and know what this train is by just looking at this kind of windscreen. But we are in this train again, and we are in it for a good reason, because if I zoom out a little bit and go... Yes, Armstrong Powerhouse sound pack available for it. I definitely had to do a video on it because I've been waiting so long for some sound packs to actually, you know, drop for this unit. Armstrong Powerhouse actually had the actual sounds already rearing to go. They just needed to implement it in after, because they were putting so much focus and stuff to their route, the wary lines. Then after that, they put their focus back onto this. They released now the sound pack for this unit, and I'm so happy because this unit definitely needed it by far. Anyway, today's scenario is going to be really nice, actually. It's not the scenario that actually comes with the sound pack. There is a 1-hour, 10-minute scenario that does come from that does come with the sound pack. But I wanted to actually do this scenario, which is on the workshop. I'll leave the link down below. It is from London Bridge to Brighton, and it is, as you can see here, London Bridge, East Croydon, Three Bridges, Haversheath, Burgess Hill, Hassocks, Preston Park, and Brighton. Let's get the doors open, and if I go somewhere where you can guys hear the doors. Nice. I never actually noticed that this front door actually opens in a slightly different way to the kind of these kind of middle doors, which pop out a little bit more. That's something I really haven't actually noticed. It's pretty cool. FPS lag will be pretty obvious here at London Bridge, but that's to be expected. Anyway, and also one thing I'm actually using is I'm using driver-only operation, which is something, a feature that actually comes with the Sound Pack Pro for this unit. So right now it says here the platform duties are complete, so I can actually control when I want to actually close the doors, which is pretty cool. But we still have things to do in terms of setting up the cab, so we can actually worry about that. Getting into this lovely cab again, we have a few more features that we can do. So taillights are currently on, I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to put the instrument lights on. Anything down here to change? We don't want to put cab lights on because that will pretty much tank our FPS. DRA is off because it's a green light. I think that's pretty much it in terms of there. You can switch, but this is also in the normal version as well, but you can switch between EP and auto brakes, which is pretty cool. And the brakes and the pressurizations of the brakes with this sound pack just sounds so good. Anything here we actually have to sort out? I think... Oh, this little thing here, which is really cool, shows you what the configuration of the lights are. So if I put the lights now on, it'll show you that it's like that. And then if you actually go out and actually have a look, it shows you the actual configuration, which is pretty cool. One thing that's also cool is that we get to, instead of like using F8 or F7 to change the destination, you can now do it in here with this cool contraption, and it's already done. But if I was to change it again, I would use 2 or 8. Just to, it's not fully like scripted in, but it's only meant to kind of swap between there. But I'm going to leave it on Brighton now, which is pretty cool, I have to say. Very nice use of it. And I even said it, remember in my first ever video of the 442, I said, couldn't this just be used to swap the destination matrix display? And thank you, Armstrong Powerhouse. You, at least you guys are listening, or you just know common sense. Like, that's been put there. Why not just use it? Other than that, nothing else really much to do. We just have to put on the reverser. That's pretty much it. Everything is raring to go. I'm going to actually close the doors from the outside and show you guys how the doors actually correctly close. They actually correctly close if I now press R. Very nice. Look at that. And oh, it just clicks in beautifully. That is what I... thank you, Armstrong Powers. Just thank you. Other than that, let's get into shunt mode. Which actually is pretty cool. Like, you get these kind of different... You have four settings. You have shunt, you have series, parallel, and weak field. And is there something I'm missing off here? Am I supposed to be in some sort of... oh, DRAs. I don't know why the DRA got turned on for some reason. But we'll just go back out now and get this train on the way. Hear its gorgeous motors, the actual proper motors of this train. Oh, one thing I actually forgot to turn off is the parking brake. Let me just shut that off. Parking brake normally stays on, and if I just, there we go, that's been done. Now if I quickly go back out. Now if we add a bit of power. There we go. Can't hear the sounds over because we have the 171 annoyingly, 170 technically, in the background with its annoying sounds, but you can hear it. The compressor will kick in at certain points as well during the journey, so you'll hear the actual proper compressor sounds that come with this unit, which was completely missed off in the actual first version, annoyingly. Right. Coming out of here. Sounds have also been done for, like, the flanging of the wheels, and the actual one thing that you can hear nicely is the connection between the shoe gears as well, lightly. It's very faintly been done in, but it's a very nice kind of effect, which actually, like, makes the kind of clanking of an actual train unit much, like, more realistic, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna slowly go down to 15. There we go. Very nice. I can't wait till, like, the compressor turns on, because you'll hear that distinct 442 compressor. Quite a nice rich amount of AI as well in this scenario, which is really good. Again, I'll leave the link down below for the scenario. But who's excited for this? I'm very happy that it's finally released and it's here for us to utilize on this great unit. Right, let's get a bit of also, all the sounds as well in the cab have been done up as well, so it's not just on the outside exterior, it is also on the interior as well. I'm very happy about it. But you can hear that kind of nice whooshing sound. Very nice stuff. I'm going to be quite, like, listening to this unit quite a lot in this video, so do forgive me if I am caught off guard, just you know, listening and just getting lost in a trance of these sounds, because these sounds are really well done. Right, let's get a little bit more power here. I like the fact that you can use, like, you can get into drive operator. Like, the things I like that come included with sound packs with Armstrong Powerhouse, like it's just brilliant that it's not all the time also about the sounds as well. It's that they add, like, extra features and stuff like that, which is just amazing in my kind of opinion. Might change it to EP brake, maybe. Or maybe we'll just change it to EP brake. Why not? I'll switch between them. Gonna have to slow down now. Let's just... There we go. Down to 45 miles per hour. And can you hear the compressor start to kick in? You can hear that little gargling. I don't know if you guys can pick it up on the sounds. But that's just the low churning there of the compressor. It obviously gets quite loud. Because obviously this unit... The biggest thing as well, that was just the drawback when this unit came out, like the standard default unit came out, was when it just I didn't hear that kind of distinct sound. And that just really pissed me off, because that was I thought that was a distinct sound of this unit that needed to be done. And I think certain units have their distinct sounds, and that like compressor sound was definitely one of the biggest things that needed to be included with this unit. But it wasn't, unfortunately. But it's good that we have like Armstrong Powerhouse. Get a little bit more power up here into the weak field. There we go, put back in series, just coast up a little bit, which will be all right. But anyway, as you guys as I've been saying, I have been enduring through exams. I have now just finished one of them out of four. This one was actually probably the biggest one in like terms of weighing up of like credits and points and stuff like this. Was definitely the biggest one, so I'm glad that it's done and it's out the way, and have three more to look forward to, which is always good. Oh, the thing I wanted to actually talk about, like I said, I wanted to get into a few things. I'm going to start doing some videos on Dovetail Games Flight School, which they kindly sent me a preview copy over, so I thought I might as well get into that and see how it is, because I've not obviously ever done any kind of flight simming kind of video content on the channel before. But I thought this might be a good kind of opportunity to start a fresh start, and obviously being Dovetail Games Flight School, which is kind of like the tutorial portion of the kind of Dovetail Games Flight Simulator that they're going to eventually make near to the end of the year. So I don't know, I think I'm optimistic. I want to see how it is, and I think it'll be cool to start maybe a new series on it. And obviously they give me a preview copy of it, so I might as well just kind of share it with you guys. So good to be back in this unit. I really do enjoy driving. This is probably one of my favorite units in the game visually, and now now the sounds have been done and they can caress my ears from now on once I'm driving at its helm. Like, again, one of the most unique cabs, definitely. This kind of windscreen kind of thing here, you really get to appreciate it. Like, I can go a bit with track IR as well. Remember, with track IR, I can just kind of move my head around, so you can kind of get the kind of geometry in here. It's very weird, very different to kind of other units of trains. There we go. Have the power off now. We can just coast a bit as well. About 5 miles away from East Croydon. And we're only operating a 5 car today, because obviously 12 cars can't really operate from London Bridge, because London Bridge does not have the kind of a capacity for 12 car class 442s. But I don't know if actually the new modernization of London Bridge, because London Bridge is getting revamped and getting kind of modernized basically into the new era, I don't know if the new station, the new London Bridge that they're making, is actually going to be able to maybe possibly even accommodate 12-car trains and 10-car trains. Maybe, I think it can accommodate 10-car trains, but I don't know if it can accommodate, I don't know if it can accommodate 12-car. That's why we're kind of operating a 5-car, because I know these 442s currently can't do 12-car. No, 10-car, they do 10-car. I do apologise, I was thinking like these are 6-cars. Oh, look at that, 5-car. Lovely. London Overground. I appreciate AI that's going the same way that I'm going, you know what I mean? Because it's always, you get to see obviously the AI that's going the other way back, the other way, like going the return journey for you, but you never get to see AI that's actually going in the same direction that you are, which is a bit sad most of the time, I feel. Let's get a little bit more power here. So it's good to see that kind of variation. A little bit of an insulated passenger. Yeah, I think one of the most, one of the only things I think complained about this sound pack was actually this passenger view, where people were saying it's a bit too insulated. You can obviously hear, like, I've been in these trains many times going to like Gatwick Airport and whatnot, and you can hear sounds within the cab. But I think this is the only. Oh yeah, and then that, what you're not supposed to see if you have track IR. But you can hear a lot more than this, but it's a bit as isolated. But then again, that's the only thing I think most, if there were any complaints, that people actually complained about the sound route, the sound pack. So it's not the worst thing, to be honest. The sounds are good in here, like where I'm right now in the driver's cab, and then outside, of course, it's all good out here. So I can't really complain, you know. It's good stuff. But these units themselves are... these units themselves are coming to the end of their... to their life expectancy, not that, well, not life expectancy, but their actual service expectancy, because obviously they are... retiring soon, because obviously we have the red 387s, and I've actually watched a few videos of them online, those Gatwick Express red 387s, and I don't know what I think of them. They look a bit like me and myself. I'm not really a fan of Electrostars, like the 377, 387 and whatnot, and even the 378. It's a bit, I don't really, they're very bland trains. They don't really have a lot of charisma, if you know what I mean, and I don't know. I feel like putting them, like putting 387s on this kind of Gatwick Express kind of role, I feel like the Gatwick Express has always had kind of, in a way, iconic locomotives and kind of like trains that have driven on this line. Like you've had the 73, very iconic. You had the Darth Vader 460s, which, even though they were shit and they were pretty unreliable, they're pretty iconic. Like, everyone remembers them as the Darth Vader train. And then you had these, which, you know, 442 Wessex, you know, class trains. These are, you know, comfy as hell. They have a lot of history. You know, they've been shuffled through, like, you know, Southwest trains and whatnot, and then and onto here. And they're still running in very good working condition. I don't know if the maintenance cost and whatnot is actually pretty high for these, or if, like, they break down a lot. I kind of get the feeling that they're pretty sturdy, reliable trains, if I think about it, or if I like kind of gave my kind of general consensus, like thinking if these were, because they don't really look like unreliable trains, if you know what I mean. Like, say the 460s, I know, were unreliable, which now they've been made more reliable with their with the new refurbished Southwest trains 458-10s or 2s or whatever it's called. But it'd be sad to see these trains go. Like, it was also sad to see like the HSD goes when the they get replaced with the class 800s. Right, entering East Croydon platform 3. What's kind of funny is we're actually not stopping at Gatwick Airport, which is kind of like this train's kind of main, you know, kind of thing. Obviously, it's most of them now are made for like express services and whatnot. That's why obviously loads of people telling me on the class 373 video I did that, like, obviously they took off the Gatwick part so they could use these trains for, like, express services, which is true. Right. I'm using the EP. I'm going to stop here at the 4-6 marker. There we go. Very nice. And doors are open. Let's go around, see what's what. Don't know when the compressors will kick in. Or whatnot. Let me go back to let's go back to auto brake. EP indicator. Oh yeah, okay, that's fine. That's just the indicator there that was on before. Did we manage to make no, we didn't. We had to be there at 8:11 and it's 14 past now, but at three bridges we're supposed to be at 8:30, so ETA is 35. Oh wow, we're kind of a bit naughty there. Sound clear of the doors. This train's ready to depart. Oh, perfect slow closing animations. Yes. Thank you. Right. Off she goes. And then compressors kicking in, as you can hear there. Oh, yes. It's hitting all the right notes, guys. What do you guys think? Like, I hope you guys agree with me. Like, this is just top-notch. Top-notch quality right here. And I just hope, like, Armstrong Powerhouse keep doing what they're doing with these kind of sound packs. It's sad to also hear that I was, like, reading, like, in terms of, like, if they're going to do any more routes. Like, obviously, they released their Wherry lines, which was pretty good for their first route compared to some other kind of, like, payware routes out there. I don't think they said they're not going to be doing one for, like, quite some time because it took quite a lot of effort to kind of, like, make this one happen with the Qwerty line. So I think they're just gonna stick with just doing either sound packs and also, like, pro train train packs. And the one that we're rather looking forward to, and if anyone hasn't forgotten still, is the Class 313 by Wagons. That's also like coming out at some point. I am looking absolutely in for like forward to that, because that train is, like, one of my favorite trains. Again, I've got quite a few different favorite trains, but Class 313, obviously it's not in the game, and that's a train that would just be so nice, obviously on many places such as the East Coast Main Line, like the wagon rail sections, you know, London Overground, where it would be like doing Silverlink Metro services, where, like, I think the liveries are involved with the 313. I think there's Wagon Rail, there's First Capital Connect, there's Silverlink, there's Southern South Coastway livery. You know, the one now that the 313s are doing in the south on the coastlines for Southern. That livery's involved. There's a few other kind of like cool odd wagon ones, and some older ones, like you know, like the Northeastern and whatever kind of liveries, BR liveries, etc. So I'm r really looking forward to when that actually, like, starts kind of nearing its release, because that's going to be quite a good one. Because generally, I think most of the train packs and stuff on Armstrong Powerhouse are not too bad. Like, say, the 321, the Class 90, and the 456 as well. Those have been really good train packs that I've enjoyed driving. Great trains that they make, but not everything they make is, you know, to the perfect thing, to the perfect scratch. 10 car, 442, passing me. I'm a bit jealous. I'm happy with our 5 car, representing well. Was good. I think we're passing Pearly Oaks, or yeah, it's just Pearly. Quite a lot of platforms here at Pearly, even though is it much? Actually, I'm guessing loads of train services stop at Pearly. It's quite a lot of platforms, and I think it's splitting off into different branches and whatnot. I assume. I kind of know everything. Like, my mind is so blanked out from, like, things, like say, things in Train Sim and whatnot in OMSI as well. Even though, like, with the OMSI one videos, like, that will kind of... I think I have 2 more OMSI videos to release for you guys, I think. And then I have, like, till episode 10 for Bus Simulator, which I'm actually really enjoying. I really like the kind of Let's Play aspect of it, and that's why I continue doing it. I know some people are, like, not really into it, but I like it, and if I enjoy doing it, then... I'll do it as a video series. I don't really care if people don't like it. If I enjoy doing it, then that's fine. But it's been so hard to kind of like relate to videos and stuff like that, and you know, talk about stuff in videos in terms of trains and stuff, because my mind is so in exam mode. I don't know if anyone else gets that, where like when in the exam season, when it's just basically exams and stuff, your mind goes into that. It focuses so much on the information and stuff that you need to learn for exams that everything else kind of becomes a bit of a second blur, and it becomes a bit annoying. It becomes like, oh yeah, like you can't really think straight on those kind of things because your mind is so focused on exams, and that's what I'm finding right now. But as I said, I'm really happy that this first exam is out of the way, and I don't have to think about it, because this is probably the one that I had to think the most about, because it's in university you have credits for different credits weigh differently for different modules, and in my course we either have 10 credit modules, which is the like norm, and then we have like bigger 20 credit modules, and this first exam that I did was a 20 credit module exam. And which is good, because now it's off my shoulders, and now I have 3 10 credit module exams left to do, and hopefully I'll get to do those ones okay. Hopefully I'm gonna just shift up into weak field, because why not get us a bit more power, even though like I feel like power should be a bit more aggressive. Well, not aggressive, I feel that it should be able to get up to like a good speed, because obviously this is the world's fastest third rail EMU. I think it can reach up to 110, I think, is the highest it can go up to, if allowed, I'm guessing. But it doesn't mean that it gets up to it in fast fashion. Definitely not. Actually slow it back down into parallel, because we are getting to the 90. I don't want to go too overboard with it. The fan as well, I think the sounds are the same, or maybe it's this change as well, but I'm not too sure. Let's have a look at it. I don't know. To me they sound the same, but anyway, fans to me in the trains and stuff like that in Train Simulator are very gimmicky. I find I don't really care too much. Like, cool, like you can turn it on and whatnot, you can, you know, again, and all the lights are now gone, so I can't turn it off. I have to wait till I get back outside from the tunnel, which we'll do right now, because I don't want a fan annoying me just fanning around. I want my subscribers to hear my beautiful voice, not some fan sounds. If you know what I mean. Oh, gonna put on shunt. The shunt model's like, it's described in the manual as like, when you put it into shunt, it only supplies enough electricity for just very slow kind of acceleration, obviously made for shunting operations, I'm guessing, where, like say, in a depot kind of scenario, wherever, where you don't want the train to just, you know, gallop forward and accelerate too fast. So it's nice. Let me see if anything on this side. I think I had a look at this thing before, but it didn't really make any sense to me. Oh, and on this side as well, you have some bird shit. Why not? Nothing specifically. I should be looking at like what's in front of me while I'm driving, but I'm using tracker to just have a look, see around, see what's what. I don't think there's anything else in this cab I haven't already seen before, but we're not here to have a look around aesthetically of the train. We're here to listen to these gorgeous sounds. And I was going to do a flyby camera there, but then a tunnel's reappeared. Do a few little flybys as well, just to hear the swooshing and just, you know, why not? We like to see a train go by once in a while. Right. Oh yes, and we're now on the little down stretch here, down to Gatwick Airport, which we're fortunately not stopping at, but I don't mind if we're not stopping there. It's fine. It is an express service to Brighton anyway, so it's nice. No biggie. And to be honest, I guess I kind of understand if the reason why you wouldn't want to stop at Gatwick, because if you're running an express to Brighton, you don't really want people to clog up in the beginning portions, or like off the beginning half of the trip, that want to just go to Gatwick, and then new people with luggage and stuff to Gatwick will just basically board the train and cause like a bit of commotion. So in a way, it's smarter not stopping at Gatwick and just going directly down and to other stops down to Brighton, because this is a Brighton Express, isn't it? A Gatwick Express. And that was a bit weird. Did you see there? It's like two trains there waiting in a queue for some reason. Might be a little bit of traffic back into the capital, which is kind of realistic in some ways as well. But it is the kind of late afternoon, early evening rush hour, so I presume that would be the kind of case. I don't know if that's kind of realistic that you would get a kind of backlog. Look like you have another train now coming back here, so you kind of are getting a kind of backlog of trains, which is kind of nice to see. But for me, going to Brighton, we're plain sailing so far. No problems on the signals, just all green, which is what I like to see. Having no problems whatsoever. I can go back to flybying. Oh, did you hear that little clank there of the shoe gear? That, oh, just love it. Like, those kind of sounds just make it just sound so much better. Good stuff. Fairly enjoying it. I've actually had some other scenarios with the 442. There was this scenario I really wanted to do as a video, which is in the Southwest Trains livery. In the kind of newish livery, not the old Southwest Network livery, like, you know, the old kind of like blue and white and red stripy kind of one. I did have a scenario of, like, even with that one as well as the newish kind of Southwest Trains livery, but for some reason they don't seem to work. I've been actually having a few little bits and problems with Train Simulator recently in terms of it just crashing, it creating save to dump file memories and what, like error messages and whatnot. And I don't know, like, I thought maybe at some point it had something to do with also like memory issues and whatnot, which I still find it's weird. I do have like 16 gigabytes of RAM, and I still find it annoying that I can't like use all of it, because obviously Train Sim is quite an old game, and I think it's built on a kind of like 32-bit architecture, and so it kind of mainly just utilizes 4 gigabytes of RAM, which is rather annoying. Hopefully the next gen version will prevail that and you know, go 64-bit and go like where we can use like, you know, 8s and even more RAM, which would be beautiful. I would so love that. But yeah, I've just been having those kind of crashes and stuff like that, and I'm thinking it's the RAM, is it my recording software as well when I'm trying to kind of record. Let me get away from the throttle, start to slow down a bit because speeding a little bit. Oh my god. I'm not gonna kid you guys, I actually got a little bit... Wow, that, I had to actually like take a second there because that actually scared the shit out of me. Like, literally, there was actually like, you guys saw it. Like, the woman just kind of crossed in front of me, and it honestly felt like I was actually running her down. I'm not even gonna lie, that actually really felt surreal. Wow, that actually really shook me up there, because it was so unexpected. Like, I saw the people like walking about, but then she just kind of veered into like in front of me, in front of my train, and then I'm just like, what? And then my mind didn't know what to do, even though I know it's a game, but it kind of just felt almost real in that kind of instance. But wow, that kind of shot me. But I need now counseling. I need like a train driving counseling, because I took an NPC's life. Oh, I need therapy now. No, I kid. But it did shake me up a little bit there. That wasn't, you know. Literally, she just came through me. It's like her soul came through me. Through the train, all over, her soul's all over the train, all bloody and all over the train. But come out to free bridges now. Just lost my tongue there. Platform 5, and we're just about maybe. We're going to be maybe a minute late, which is, I'm happy with that, to be honest. Even though we had like an ETA of being 5 minutes late, we managed to cut down that journey time, which is good. I'm very happy with that. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now entering Free Bridges. There we go. Perfect. Excellent start. You hear the popping there of the doors. All good. Doors are open. People are ready to disembark or embark. How are we doing in terms of time? Well, it hasn't told us yet, but we're a minute. I think a minute late's all right, and we're supposed to depart. Might give us a next, but I feel we've kind of caught up there, so I hope it gives us a tick. Then our next station is Hayward's Heath. Five juniors compete. Okay, stand clear of the doors. Wait for that pause where the doors are actually closing. And then that little light flashes up, tells us, yep, we're ready to go. Break off. And let's get rolling. I wonder what these... I've been fascinated. What are these? Because if this is the door button, is this the, like, open all doors? I'm guessing. I'm not too sure. Because those lights pop on and off. It's really, I don't know if there's anyone who actually an answer for like what these are at the top here. I feel that they're the open door buttons. I feel like the driver would press them, they'd come on, and then obviously you would press, like, say if it's driver only operation, you'd press then the door close button. and then, you know, that those would turn off, that would turn on. That's the only kind of thing I'd presume. I don't know. But it's cool that they I don't think in the default version that these would turn on and off. I'm not too sure. But that's a nice little feature as well. See, Armstrong Powerhouse, like, you know, they give you these kind of little nice extra bits, and I appreciate that. Like, they really don't have to. Like, the sounds themselves would just suffice me, and I would be a very happy person with just the sounds. But I like that they do those kind of little things. This computer thing up here where they've allowed you to, you know, do the actual changing of the destination matrix display, that you can actually change it with this kind of computer by pressing like 2 and 8 and that, and that's just nice, because then you don't have to actually press, you know, F8, F7 and do it for your keyboard, and then you're pressing actually something within the cab, and that makes it, I feel, much more kind of realistic, and it just adds that kind of bit of immersion, and I really do appreciate that, like, thoroughly. Need to go up to parallel. I'm just realizing we're only sticking around like 40 miles per hour in series, which is similar to, I think it's, what is it, similar to like the class 7.3? Like, I remember when I was driving that, which I was still kind of a bit confused out, because I preferred actually driving in diesel mode, where you just go to 100% and diesel just, you know, takes over. But in the electric version, where you actually had the parallel and the series and the weak field and whatnot, I was kind of getting confused. Like, I guess, like, obviously series is to bring it up to speed, and in parallels to like go faster in the kind of high speed. So it's basically just gears, like for electric trains in a way. So series is like 1 to 2 to 3, and then parallel is 4, 5, and then weak field, I'm presuming, is like 6, 7th gear in a way. If I was to kind of translate these as actual like car gears or engine gears. Even though technically motors don't really have gears, because they're just one moving thing, and you're just really increasing the voltage or the amps to kind of like make that moving part go faster. But I have actually read in the manual that when you put it into series, that the bogies on the carriage, so like you have electric motors on each of the bogies, or some of the selected bogies, and then when it's in series, both the bogies work in unison, and then in parallel, I don't know which way it's round, but it's, I think it's series only selected bogies, like, are on, and then parallel, all of them are on, I do believe. Or something like that, I don't know. If you get this Armstrong Powerhouse 442 Wessex Soundtrack Pro and read actually through the manual, it actually tells you, because it gives you a bit of history as well of like how the things work in this unit in terms of like what they were trying to actually simulate, which is pretty cool. Like this unit in real life does work on the kind of series parallel kind of weak field kind of thing, even though on the figure it says 1, 2, 3, 4, which probably says in real life, but the actual train itself probably works on this series parallel weak field kind of electronic basis, as I'm guessing, and all that kind of good jazz. Another thing I want to mention as well, I don't know if many people have been doing this, I have had a few messages from a couple of people that have been saying that they've been joining in and doing this, is as you know, recently in one of my past videos, I did say I'm going to return transcribing videos back to where people can, I invite people with a link in the description for you guys to come and transcribe my videos and translate my videos, so my videos can have subtitles into like foreign watchers, like non-English speaking watchers, so they can like watch and understand what I'm saying in other countries, and also people like with hearing impairments and whatnot, they can have like English subtitles on the screen, or maybe even people that are just totally normal but want also English subtitles on the screen, actual ones that work instead of the ones that are automatically generated by YouTube. So in the description of this video, you'll get you'll have that link saying transcribe this video, and it'll take it to a place where you can type in what I say, and Yeah. I'll mention it every now and again or whatever, but yeah, I'm just keeping that in every single video now, video description now, to a link where you can transcribe my videos and give them cool subtitles and whatnot, and I'll definitely be sure to credit people that fully like submit a like transcribe video or whatnot as well. I'll give credit. But yeah, link to that and will be in the description, as well as the previous, like, I don't know how many videos prior to this I've put that link in the description for, but most should, and I'll probably go back and add that kind of link to most of my older videos as well at some point as well. Let's lower down to parallel. Actually, we're coming up quite nicely up to Qwerty Afro, and we're actually going to arrive there, I think, just about on time, which is really, really nice. And actually, let me just have a quick check. Did we... Yes, we managed to get the tick. That is really good. I'm really happy about that. So we're kind of on time-ish now. We're no longer late, which is nice to know. Gonna reduce now the power there. We don't really need it anymore. And I'm gonna stop braking, because is that a red for me? I don't think it is. I think that's for the left outer track, but we do have a double yellow. Oh, and now it's a green. Plain sailing, as I said. To hear a bit of the braking action. Oh, you can hear the, yeah, that's nice. Yeah, compressor in there. You can hear the nice, oh, the brakes, and it just sounds like the actual train. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Qwerty Afro. This is a... What would you say? Is this a Southern? Govia Southern service? Or would you just say this is an Express? A Govia Express? I'm guessing it's Govia. It would just be like, this is a Govia Express service to Brighton. The next station is Burgers Hill. Oh, lovely. That compressor is special. It's definitely special. Love it. But we're at Qwerty Afro. All good. I wish this scenario, like, I wish it was a scenario where I connected up to another 5-car, another 5-car 442. That would have been really cool. But I'm not gonna complain, you know. It's actually nice driving, you know, the 5-car once in a while. You know, 10-car's cool, but you know, 5-car's cool. Three 77 coming in. Oh no, passing. And I think I have the sound pack as well. I think I have the sound pack for the 377, the 455 in this scenario, the 465, something like that, 466, or have most of the sound packs for like most of the AI in this scenario. Stay clear of the doors. Oh, the most orgasmic doors in Train Simulator to date. I think... Were there any other ones that I said that were... I think I said the ICE 3 doors were quite orgasmic. These doors beat it, hands down. Fantastic. The only thing now which would just make it good is if, you know, we had sparks and, like, third rail spark. You know, we have sparking of, like, pantographs in this game, but we don't have any third rail spark, which is deeply annoying. Like, you know, a bit of... That would make it, like, really cool. Like, you just hear the nice little spark thing and have an animation with it. That would really look aesthetically very nice. Very pleasing to the eye as well. Even though, to be honest, with third rail trains, like say when I've been, like, travelling mainly, like, say, on Southwest trains, which is predominantly third rail... You do get third rail sparking and stuff like that. I don't think you get it as much as pantograph kind of spark. And also, like, with pantographs, you hear that kind of ticking sound quite a lot. That kind of electric kind of ticking kind of noise with any kind of pantograph. You don't even have to have sparking. You'll still hear that kind of ticking thing, the electric tick. But with third rail shoe gears, you don't really hear any kind of electrical kind of contact or whatever, unless it sparks. So, I don't know. But it would be nice if you could, like, have that in the game. Because it's something that does happen. And is this a... No, it's not. It's now turned into a green, which is very nice. I almost got afraid that that red light next to it was the actual red light for the next signal, which would have terrified me a little bit there. I really wouldn't have wanted it to be that. All quiet. I like that little baggage up there. You know, even though there's no one in the train. Oh, horn. I had to do two things there. I had to do the two-toned horn as well as the AWS. I had to use my fingers there, stretch them out over the B, the space, and the Q key. But again, I'm interested in doing that series, as I said, with Dovetail Games Flight School. As they sent me the preview copy, I'm very interested to see how that goes and see how you guys might react to it and enjoy it, I don't know. As well as, one thing I'm a bit concerned is that we haven't heard anything really, again, still about the next-gen version of Train Simulator, the Unreal Engine 4 one. I'm still a bit annoyed that we have not heard anything about it. I feel... that since it was announced last year, beginning of last year, till now, like, what has been said about it? Nothing. It's like, it's almost been, like, shoveled under a rug. And I feel this year, there's not going to be really much said about it, because obviously, Dovetail Games are going to be focusing mainly on Dovetail Games Flight Simulator and Flight School. Like, I'm guessing that's where most of the attention will be this year. So, I wish... they would post, like, I really wish they would get the community a bit more involved and just tell us, like, what's the kind of thoughts and processes and stuff going in the preliminary stages of, like, I don't even know if this next-gen game is in preliminary stages, but it would be nice to know what the kind of ideas and stuff flowing around the office and of, like, what are they trying to achieve with this next-gen version. If you know what I mean, like, I would love to know, I'd love to hear and love to, you know... Because I feel we're kind of being left in the dark, and I feel then it kind of feels like, are they still doing this? Or do they really care about this? I don't know. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Burgersill. This is a Govia Express train to Brighton. The next station is Hassocks. This train is formed of 5 coaches, fast class available. I do believe it was in. If I can shut. No, I can't shuffle with this open. Ah! First class is available in the 3rd middle coach. And I don't think. Well, I think this is only driver operation, as most Gatwick Express services in real life are. Well, I think all of them are driver-operated only, and I think there's a big row going on with, like, driver unions with the new 387s, which will be obviously taking over the Wessex 442 class trains. And the big debate is that these new 387s, I think they're going to be even 12-car. I think they're going to have some 10, but most of them are going to be now 12-car. And I think Govia wants basically them to be driven with just a driver, a 12-car train with just a driver, no guard on board. And I think that's causing quite a lot of row with train drivers, saying that that's a bit ridiculous. I think most of their contracts only say that they can drive a train up to 10 coaches, like, you know, by themselves or whatever, or something like that. And it's a bit ridiculous in a way, because there's no guard on a 12-car train. I feel, and then the driver's the only one, like, you know, responsible. It's a bit hectic. And then they're, like, repositioning the name of driver guard to, like, a journey, like, assistant or something like that. I'm not too sure. Or, like, a train supervisor. That's they're trying to, like, rename the train guard kind of role and reshuffle jobs around and stuff. Like, I don't know. It's a interesting discussion to have. Right. Let us roll from we're going to Hassocks. I was going to say we're departing from Hassocks, but no, we're going to Hassocks now from Burgess Hill. I like the actual progressive acceleration of this unit. It definitely feels a lot more realistic to how the actual unit accelerates in real life compared to the Dovetail Games version, which felt like you just hit the accelerator and the train just, you know, got off the line. Which was another one of the main issues with the Class 455, the Southern Class 455, where that train had the most ridiculous acceleration physics I think I've ever seen for, like, a train that old. That for a train that old should not be able to, like, just get off the line like that. Even most modern trains don't, like, you know, literally jump 0 to 20 in, like, 1 second. So I was a bit annoyed with that, and then obviously with this unit, but at least now it kind of feels more realistic to how it would slowly build up, because these are old trains, they're not going to just get off the line straight away. But I do love, like, some of the kind of stories and stuff, like, I have, like, say, when I've had these kind of journeys on these Gatwick Express 442 Wessex trains, is, like, I think the best journey I think I had on it is when I took the first ever the first service out of London Victoria, and, like, the one of the mornings where I went to Gatwick to go, I think it was to Cyprus. And catching the first Wessex train out of Victoria to Gatwick Airport is really nice in the morning, where it's, like, just, like, kind of, you know, just fresh from the depot, and then it kind of chugs out of London Victoria, and it's magical. All the you're just, like, hearing the train just basically wake up. It's, like, as grouchy and stiff as your body is in the morning when you roll out of bed. They're the same as a train. Especially in a bit of an old train, which has to kind of, like, you know, Well, I'm guessing this doesn't have fluids and stuff like that, but it's still, like, it's an old motor. It needs to kind of crank up a bit. But definitely one of the most comfortable trains I've pretty much ever driven on. What am I saying driven on? Rode on. Like I've been allowed to drive these trains in real life. Yeah, I've just, driven these. It's definitely the most comfortable trains ever. I'm a little bit slow into this station. There we go. I think anywhere here really should be fine. Let's quickly slip out of her DMs and there we go. Ooh, that pop. Oh, that pop was very nice. This is the only first class bit, and then it goes into... What is this? Is this like a baggage car area? And go, like, for, like, luggage and stuff and whatnot, I'm presuming. That's what I'm guessing. But I thought first class was much bigger than this part. Like, I'm pretty sure, like, there was a car... Like, when I drove on it, there was, like, a carriage worth of first class, but that's like only like half a carriage. But maybe this is a 442 that's just exclusively used on like express services, where then it's not really used for Gatwick Express, where on the Gatwick Express they would, I'm guessing, you know, have like more need for like first class seats. Very nice. Next station is Preston Park, so we're like actually really close to Brighton now. Second to last stop now coming up, and then it's pretty much Brighton. And this journey will end. And I have to say, I've really enjoyed it. I really like it. It's been a nice, relaxing video for me to make. A really nice, relaxing journey with this really, oh, lovely addition to the game in terms of third-party add-ons with this. Class 442 Pro sound pack from Armstrong Powerhouse, like, really good. It's like so funny to think that these sounds that they've had these sounds for years. They had these sounds way before this train was actually introduced into Train Simulator by Dovetail Games. So it's kind of funny that they've had these sounds on standby. And again, the only reason we're getting this sound pack now is because obviously they were gonna, I think they were gonna release it before the Qwerty lines, but I think then the Qwerty lines kind of project like took most of their time, so they kind of put like sound packs and stuff on hold, and now they're kind of gonna go flat out with like different other kind of sound packs that they'll release in the future. I don't know what the next one, I think the next one was for like some sort of diesel locomotive unit, I'm not too sure. But then again, as I said, another exciting to look forward to is the Class 313 that they're going to be releasing with wagons. Which that, if the sounds as well are done good, Armstrong Powerhouse and people that make trains should just get together and... You know, love is created. It's weird, like, I don't know why, like, Dovetail Games and, like, Armstrong Powerhouse haven't, like, you know, partnered up to do things together. Like, I've heard, like, somewhere that they tried to, like, Dovetail Games tried to, but, like, certain things, like, between them and Armstrong Powerhouse, like, there's certain disagreements and stuff like that, so they can't work together and whatnot, but... Hey-ho, we're still, at least, like, you know, it's not like Armstrong Powerhouse are going to stop making stuff, at least they can, you know, still make like third-party add-ons and stuff like that, so I'm happy. But I hope, again, in the next-gen version of Train Simulator, I feel that that sentence is just a very common one on this channel. I feel in the next version of the next-gen version of Train Simulator there should be. But I hope in the next, in the next-gen version, I hope that like sounds and stuff and like quality control of like routes and trains and stuff are taken a lot more seriously than in this game. I feel that they've gotten away quite a lot in this game, and again, it's to do with Train Simulator by Dovzo Games being like really the only main train simulator out there on the market. There's nothing competing with it, which means that Dovetail Games can do whatever they really like, to be honest, because people are pretty much only going to buy from Dovetail Games for Train Simulator content. Because where else are you going to get like a Train Simulator like this? Nowhere, really. You'd either have to go for something that's like free and tacky, like BVE or something like that, or like go old and get stuff like from like Microsoft Train Simulator kind of days and stuff like that. There's nothing really else out there or really like bite your teeth and actually buy trains with a Z simulator. So I don't know, like it's been always like that because Dovetail pretty much owned the market with Train Simulator kind of content, so no one, there's no other choice, so we just have to kind of give in and buy into them, and that's why they make money, that's why they basically continue doing that, because if they see that it's making them a lot of money, then they don't really care. They don't have to increase the quality of things, they don't have to keep the quality control the same for all of their DLC and stuff like that, because they don't have to, they make money anyway. Why should they waste extra resources and time and energy and like trying to make everything 100% when they can make things that are 50%, 40%, 80%, 95% charge the same thing and actually make a return and actually run the business and make money? Like, in a way, if I was running a business and I was the only one really selling this type of product and everyone was coming to me, even though I might sell it like in a, like, you know, I might sell something crappy or like I might not take care in a certain model or something like that, if people were still coming because I'm the only one that provides that service for that product or whatever and I still make a shitload of money, why should I spend the time, extra resources trying to perfect? And I don't know, but you do have companies that, you know, even though they might be the only one that provides a certain service or whatever, they still take it in themselves to do things 100% and, you know, quality is their, like, number one kind of thing. But, you know, who knows? Who knows, guys? Who knows? Coming up to Preston Park. Very sad it's coming to an end. I need to think of oh god, am I gonna run over running a little bit? No. Come on. That will do for me. I'm not too bothered about that. But now I have to release the brake. That should be fine. I think that was an emergency. There is this kind of brake kind of sound that you get when the brake kind of has to repressurize, which sounds really cool. Was that a 377? Yeah. I need to think of a little secret word also to give you guys, because this has been a rather long video. I might as well give you guys this little secret word for all you guys that have come up to this point of the video. I think the secret word shall be... What should the secret word be? I don't know. Number one orgasmic doors. Oh god, it's not really a word, but you can either use that, you can either put in the comments down below number one orgasmic doors if you came to this kind of point of the video near the end, or you can use a simple keyword of Govia. How about that? That would be the secret word. So if you've reached this point of the video, like normally when I do these kind of really long over an hour videos, I tend to kind of give people some keywords to kind of type in the comments to just... so I can see who's kind of actually got to this point of the video, who's a true subscriber to QWERTY Afro. But yeah, so it's either number one orgasmic doors if you want to type that in fully, or if you don't want to type in a full sentence, you can type in Govia as the kind of magical word, as I've done in previous kind of longer videos and stuff like that. You'll be part of the special club. Right, this time I really don't want to... Let's go back to EP break. Because I don't want to... I can't overrun here at Brighton, because if I overrun, I go into a buffer. And that would look rather stupid. Right, down to 25. I hopefully should. There we go. And 25. Entering platform 6. Do we maybe go into a back of a another 5-car 442? That would be a nice way to end it. Or maybe we'll go in by ourselves to an empty platform. I'm totally cool with that. Two 319s there on the further platform. Start slowing down. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now arrived at Brighton, where this train terminates. Please do take all your personal belongings with you when... Just a sec, just let me stop the train and I'll be back with you. Yes, thank you. It is Brighton. Please all change. Please do take all your personal belongings with you when leaving the train. This is the last stop. Thank you for boarding on this Govia Express service. Let me just put on the taillights. There we go. Perfect. Oh, look at that. That is class right there. On the money, guys. Oh, that is just... Oh, so... You know what? I think this... Oh, no. I can't do it as a screenshot, can I? Yes, I can. I believe I can. I'm just gonna have to... No, I can't! No, it's gonna fuck me over like that. You know what, I'm gonna take a screenshot. No, I can't take a screenshot because this overlays thing... Okay, so I can't take a screenshot here. That is really, really super annoying. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It's fine. We're here. Look at the... Oh, just look at that. Gorgeous trains. They will be missed. They really will be missed. We didn't complete the scenario, which is annoying. I think we didn't complete it because we were late to that. Where were we? Oh, and I didn't pick up at one platform, which is probably the one I overran, which I'm not too bothered about. Anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed that. It was a nice de-stressed video for me to kind of do after that first really big exam, and I've definitely enjoyed it doing it back in the class 442. Wessex units with the Armstrong Powerhouse Soundprep Pro for it, and it is definitely worth the buy. If you definitely want to get much more immersion out of this this train, this sound pack is definitely the one for you. The link to it will be down below, so you can check it out on Armstrong Powerhouse's website. The link to the scenario that I drove in this video will be down below, as well as the link to the actual Steam page of this class 442 unit. The shoutouts again in this video go to class 380 fan and Abdoulie Secka. That's again across class 380 fan and Abdoulie Secka. The links and stuff will be down below. Show them some love. Other than that, guys, I hope you guys have a beautiful day. If you guys are going through exams and whatever, good luck. Get through it. It'll be fine. It'll be over. The summer is upon us soon. Hashtag soon. Anyway, other than that, I hope you guys have a great day. I'll catch you guys in another video. Bye. We ain't never giving up cause we ain't born for that. Gotta catch a fast you do. The ship is cruising, it's true.